plus is called as increment operator, minus minus is called as decrement operator. There are different types of what operators are available. So as a developer, you must know when to use which operator. Arithmetic operators, already we have some clarity. Relational operators, whenever we solve an expression or whenever you want to compare any two values, then you have to use relational operators. For example, if I ask one question, something like this. Okay, now. Amazon is giving an offer. Amazon is giving an offer. An offer for their customers. For their customers. What offer they are giving? If the total bill is greater than 5,000, 10% discount. 10% discount on the total bill, on total bill. Okay, now let us consider three items cost is, one is 2,000, one is 3,000, one is 4,000. So first what to do? Calculate solution, find the solution for the problem. How to find the solution? Step number one, calculate total bill. Step number two, check whether total bill is greater than 5,000. Step number three, then calculate what? Discount. Okay, na? Total bill. So how to calculate total bill? Some calculations we can do here. Calculate total bill, 2,000 plus 3,000 plus what? 4,000. And then this, so total bill is total 4,5,6,7,8,9,000 is the total bill. Then check total bill. So 9,000 is greater than 5,000. So eligible to get the discount. Eligible to get a discount. Just basic mathematics is enough. So calculate discount. Calculate discount. How to calculate discount? 9,000. How much percentage discount? 10% discount. 9,000 into 10 by 100. 9,000 into 10 by 100. So how much discount he will get? By 100. 00. 900 rupees discount he will get. So the net bill. Net bill is what? Paid bill. Paid bill must be 9,000 minus 900. How much? 8,100. Okay, na? Like this. To solve this problem, you have to use what? Arithmetic operators. First, here you have to use arithmetic operators. Here you have to use relational operators. Yes or no? This is the what we have to discuss here. Okay, now how to do this program, that we'll see later. Okay, now. Next one is logical operators. Logical operators. Logical operator means what? Comparing two or more expressions and return a Boolean value. It is used to compare two or more expressions and return a Boolean value. That is logical operators. Okay, now let us assume here expression 1 and here expression 2. The expression are conditions. Logical operators means it is used to compare two or more conditions and return a Boolean value. And return a Boolean value. That is true or false. Let us assume this is the truth table. Condition 1, condition 2, end operator, or operator. Condition 1 is true. End operator will return true if both the conditions are true. Or operator will return true if either of the condition is true. False, true, false, true. False, 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 false. End operator will return true if both the conditions are true. For example, here let us take some examples. 5 greater than 3 and 5 less than 3. 5 greater than 3 is what? True. 5 less than 3, false. So the output is what? False. Same I will write in another manner. 5 greater than 3 or 5 less than 3. 5 greater than 3, true. 5 less than 3, false. R operator will return true if either of the condition is true. End operator will return true if both the conditions are true. Sir, everyone, let us take one small problem or requirement. What is the requirement? Same requirement I will give. Amazon will give offer. Amazon will give offer discount for the customer. For the customer whose total bill is greater than 5,000 and whose card is Citibank card. Okay, na? So condition one is what? Total bill must be greater than 5,000 and whose card equal to Citibank debit card. So here customer one total bill is 6,000 and card is ICICI Bank. Customer two, total bill is 4,000 or 5,000 and here the bank is Citibank. Customer three, total bill is 7,000 and bank is Citibank. Customer four, total bill is 12,000. Bank is ICICI Bank. So identify which customer will get the discount. Which customer is eligible to get a discount. Tell me, which customer is eligible to get the discount? First customer, condition one is what? 6,000 greater than 5,000, true. Card is ICICI Bank, false. So result is false, not eligible. Yes or no? Second customer, 5,000 greater than 5,000, false. Citibank, true. End operator we have to use here. Okay, now, because both the conditions must be satisfied. Third option, 7,000 greater than 5,000, true. Bank is also Citibank card only. True. And fourth customer, this is true, this is false, so false. So customer three is eligible to get discount. This is common sense. You have to read the problem several times. 99% in question only, what will have? Answer will be there. If you read the question properly, just you are doing some Amazon shopping cart application is there. Customer purchased what items? If the customer total bill is 5,000 and if the customer card is Citibank, then only he will get what? Discount. Otherwise, no discount. Amazon will give 30% discount for the customer whose total bill is greater than 5,000 and whose card is Citibank. Sir, how to write the program, that we will see later when we go to PDLC. I will tell you one life cycle mechanism to solve the problems also. See this guy. Angular or React, which one is best nowadays? First you concentrate on the class here. Indigo star of the class will give. I am teaching logical programs. You are asking unnecessary questioning now. First, to concentrate on logic, lot of concentration is required. That is about logical programs. Did you understand logical operators? Assignment operator is used to assign the value, that we'll see. What is assignment operator? Let us see. First of all, before going to assignment operator, you must have the knowledge on variables. So first of all, I will teach you about variables. Okay, now here let us consider what is variable. Simply you can tell variable is the name given for a particular memory location. Next, what is the purpose of variable? What is the purpose of variable? simple point. The purpose of variable is to store the value. The purpose of variable is to store the value. Is it clear? Variable is the name given for a particular memory location. What is the purpose of variable? Purpose of variable is to store the value. Next point, how many values we can store? How many values we can store in a single variable? In a single variable, only single value. One variable we can store only one value. Next one, what is variable declaration? How to create a variable? How to create variable by using data type? Syntax to declare variable. Syntax is data type variable name semicolon int x semicolon. Is it clear? Next, here I will ask you, what is equal operator? What is equal operator? Here you can tell something like equal is equal to is called as assignment operator. What is the purpose of equal operator? The purpose of equal operator is to assign the value. Assign the value to the variable. If you want to assign the value to the variable, you have to use equal operator. Are you following? Assignment to give answers, sir. Very good, yaar. Very great student. Dot. Your name is dot or what? Better to keep comma instead of dot. What is the purpose of equal operator? Don't be hyperactive. Okay. The purpose of equal operator is to assign the value to the variable. So rules to be followed. While declaring variables. Okay, now mostly these rules I am recommended for Java and .NET and TypeScript, not Python. Is it clear? Now, if you want, I will write one more question. What is the difference between equal and double equal? Okay, now equal is called as assignment operator. Double equal is called as comparison operator. If you want to compare two values, use double equal. If you want to assign the value to the variable, use single equal. I am from India, not from Telangana or Andhra Pradesh. Elijah. I am an Indian. Is it clear? Kannababu belongs to India, not only from Telangana. People are throughout the India, different places. So you respect me like an Indian instead of my regional things. Okay. Rules to be followed while declaring variable. Rule number one, variable name must not be a number. Okay, variable name must not be a number. Here you can write int x into 10 semicolon, you will get error. Point number two, variable name must not consist of spaces. Int emp space number semicolon, error. Point number three, variable name must start with lowercase character. Int emp number, error will not come, invalid. Int emp number, this is valid. Okay, na? Point number four, variable name must not be a keyword. So you can ask me, what is keyword? What is keyword? Keyword is a reserved word. Keyword is a reserved word which have a special meaning. Which have a special meaning. Yes or no? Keyword is a reserved word which have a special meaning. Both int emp number is same, sir. Emp number. Here E capital. Okay, okay. Okay, na? Keyword is a reserved word which have a special meaning. Int. Example for keywords. In any language, you take static, void, na, if, else, for, while, do, etc. These all are keywords. Int do semicolon, error. Agar int if semicolon, error. Variable name must not be a number. Variable name must not consist of spaces. Variable name must start with, okay, na? Lowercase character. Variable name must not be a keyword. Okay. Variable name must not be true, false, null. Int true semicolon, error. Variable name must not be true, false, null. Are you following everyone? Next point number 6. We cannot store multiple values. We cannot store multiple values in a single variable. We cannot store multiple values in a single variable. Int x is equal to something like this. You will get the error. One variable we can store only one value. Point number 6. Point number 7. Whenever we modify the variable value, then the previous value will be erased. Then the previous value will be erased. Yes or no? One variable we can store only one value. Int x is equal to 5. And here if I write x is equal to 6. Here is equal to is assignment operator. The value 5 was assigned to x. So initially what value is stored in x? 5. Now in the line number 2, we are assigning the value 6. Yes or no? Once when we are assigning the value 6, the old value is what? Erased. The old value is erased. One variable we can store only one value. We cannot store multiple values in a single variable. Whenever you modify the variable value, then the previous value will be erased. Whenever we modify the variable value, then the previous value will be erased. Variable purpose is to store the value. We cannot store multiple values in a single variable. Are you following? Everyone? One variable we can store only one value. We cannot store multiple values in a single variable. Yes or no? That is a very powerful point. So now let us see some valid and invalid declarations. Some case study. I'll give you some case study. Let us see which one is valid and which one is invalid. Okay, na? First one, int x semicolon. Int y is equal to 10 semicolon. Int a comma b semicolon. Int a semicolon b semicolon. Int a is equal to 10 comma b is equal to 20 semicolon. Okay, na? Int what you can tell? A is equal to 10 semicolon, b is equal to 20 semicolon. Otherwise, change the names if you're confused. Int c is equal to 10 semicolon, d is equal to 20 semicolon. Int sir, no. Some of the valid and invalid declarations. So tell me, first one is valid or invalid? First one is valid or invalid?
Valid.
Now it's invalid.
Very good. Okay, na?
Uh-huh.
Some of the valid and invalid variable declarations. Okay, na? You must have the knowledge on what are the valid and invalid variable declarations. Variable purpose is to store the value. If I ask one question here, what is the difference between comma and semicolon? Okay, na? Simply you can tell, comma is called as separator. Semicolon is called as terminator. Semicolon is called as terminator. Okay, na? Comma is used to separate two variables. Semicolon is used to end the statement. Every statement must end with what? Semicolon. Is it clear, everyone? Data type, some of the variable declarations, assignments, all these things you must have the knowledge. So what is a variable? Variable is the name given for a particular memory location. The purpose of the variable is to store the value. How many values we can store in a single variable? Single value. One variable we can store only one value. We cannot store multiple values in a single variable. We cannot store multiple values in a single variable. One variable we can store only one value. Point 3 is valid means, point 3, this is a declaration to variable. First value is stored in A, second value is stored in B. Yes or no? If I write like this, int k comma l is equal to 6 comma 5, this is also invalid, I think. It will not support like this. Once check this one in your programming languages. Okay. That is invalid actually. Have you completed the tasks, previous tasks, everyone? Now you tell me, identify the valid identifiers from the below list. This is one case study, you try all of you. By seeing the above rules, you try valid identifiers, valid and invalid. Here also I will give some more. Given syntax is correct or not, you have to identify. These all I will give. Case study, homework. Asan, no? I will share all everything in the group. Int x is equal to 10, valid. Int not valid, I is capital. So invalid. Char gender is equal to M, not valid. Single quotes is missing here. Byte roll number underscore is equal to 200, valid. And one more point I will tell here. Point number 8. Variable name must not consist of special characters except underscore. Tomorrow morning we have free core Java batch is there at 11 a.m. IST. Free core Java at 11 a.m. IST. Anyone want to attend, you can attend this batch. How to register for this batch? Just go to Satya. You got some clarity. Yes or no? So let us see some small programs. Small. Because slowly we have to increase the doses. Consider F name. Consider x is 5, y is 3, print x comma y. So here x is what? Variable. Here x is what? Variable. Y is what? Variable. 5 and 3 are values. So we have to store the value in the variable. X is equal to 5. Now here 5 is what type? Integer type. So decide the data type, int. And y is 3. Int y is equal to what? 3. So print x. So if you want to print the statement in Java, you have to print like this. System.out.println of x. You have to print like this. and system dot out dot println of y. Here mixed students are there now, so I'm writing in different languages. This is Java syntax. If you want to print in C#.NET, you can print like this, console dot right line, W capital, L capital, console dot right line of X. This is for .NET students syntax to print the value X and Y. And if you are a JavaScript student, you have to write document dot write of print X. And if you are a TypeScript student, you have to write console dot log of print X. And if you are a Python student, you have to write print X. That's it, simple. And if you're a SQL student, you have to write print @X. It depends on language to language, because logic is common for any student. Console means that is in Java, command prompt. If you want to print the output in the console, command prompt, black color screen, this is command prompt. If you want to print the output in the command prompt, console. Yes or no? So these are different. If you are Java, follow this. .NET, follow this. JavaScript, everyone follow this. TypeScript, follow this. Python, follow this. SQL, follow this. Did you understood? Semicolon is not required for Python. Okay, very good. If you are in a VB.NET, again the syntax will change. From language to language, the syntax will change. Concepts and logics concept will not change. Rules and syntax will change from one language to another language. Identify the variable names and what? Const is a data type. Not data type, it is a keyword. Const is a keyword. Const means the value which cannot be modified. I will tell that const later. Tomorrow we'll discuss on that. Did you got clarity, everyone?
Yes.
So for time being, we'll go for what? Which language will go? Consider X is 5 and here Y is 3. Print sum, comma, difference. See, simple now. You have to identify the variable names. You have to identify what? Variable names. Yes or no? My girlfriend is my wife. Yeah. After making wife, you make your girlfriend. First girlfriend means that is not good, I think. Are you following? Okay, stop chatting. Enough. Thank you. So here you see, consider X is 5, Y is 3, print sum, comma, difference. So what to do? Identify the variables. X is 5 means X is equal to 5. So decide the data type based on the value that we store. Int X is equal to 5. See, Y is 3 means int Y is equal to 3. Generally, we'll go for int only. Any data type, you'll go for int. And here you can write something like print. Just I'll go for Python print X. So if you want to print the sum, Python also don't have data types. So generally, we'll go for any language, Java or .NET, your wish. So here you can write. What to do? Find the sum. How to find the sum? Add X plus Y and store the result in Z. So here what to do? Here you see, I will write one point here. Add X comma Y and store the result in Z. And then I will try to print Z. Simple common sense. X plus Y, store the result in Z. So X is what? Integer. Y is what? Integer. Integer plus integer is what? Integer. Okay, now then you can print Z here. Print Z. Which language you want, you can write that one there. Okay, now print Z. Are you following? So decide the data type based on the value that we store. For example, if I ask one more question, consider X is 5, Y is 3.2. 3.2. Okay, now add x comma y and store the result. Store the result in z. And store the result in z. And here you can write print z. So what to do? X is 5. So x is equal to 5. So x is what? Integer. And y is 3.2. Y is equal to 3.2. So y is what? Double. Double y is equal to 3.2. Int x is equal to what? 5. Yes or no? Now add x comma y. That is x plus y you add. And store the result in z. So your x is what? Int. Y is what? Double. Int plus double is what? Double. So how to decide the data type? Based on the value that way? Store. I will tell you one more point here. In variables only, I will tell you one more point. Point number 9. Left hand side of assignment operator consider as variable. And right hand side of assignment operator consider as value. Okay. For example, let us see here. Int x is equal to 5. Here x is variable and 5 is value. Okay. And then I will write int y is equal to x. Here y is variable and the value of x. Here y is variable and the value of x, that is how much? 5 was assigned to y. Did you understood? Left hand side of assignment operator consider as variable. Right hand side of assignment operator consider as value. Here left hand side. Show me your left hand. Yes, that is x. Right hand 5. So left hand x is variable, right hand y is value. If right hand side variable is there, consider as value. If right hand side variable is there, consider as what? Value. Are you following everyone? Yes or no? So now here right hand side x, here x means how much? Here x means how much?
5.
Y means how much?
3.2.
So 5 plus 3.2.
7.2.
10.2 is assigned to what?
8.2, sir.
8.2 is assigned to what? Z.
In Z.
Z.
Whenever we will declare integer Z, then we will pin print 8, no, sir?
Into you will get error because you cannot store double value in where?
8.2.
Integer.
We cannot declare
total result is double, no, sir.
Integer equal so that's to integer plus double.
X is equal to 5.6. You will sir, get what?
Sir, what if we use where?
What if we use?
Where?
Where you use it for where JavaScript, yeah.
JavaScript you can use here. Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Index is equal to 5.6. You will get what?
Error. Because it is double.
Yes, we cannot store a double value in
integer value.
Yesterday he was said, no.
Okay, everyone. Now, anyway.